Welcome to the University of Rochester's Pathology video series. This video reviews the normal histology of the breast. In this video, we will be reviewing the virtual slides URH 168 and 169 on the URMC Digital Slides website. Here is a low power view of the breast on slide 168. The histology of the breast can be loosely divided into the ductal system, including the terminal ductal lobular units, or TDLU, and the surrounding stroma. Additionally, there is a nipple areolar complex, which will not be focused on here, but can be seen in slide 170. The terminal duct lobular units are the functional units of the breast. They consist of the terminal ductules and lobules, which we will focus on as we discuss the breast epithelium. The breast has two types of cells in the lobules. We can observe the first one, the luminal epithelial cells, here as a cuboidal shaped cells on the inner layer. The other cell type is the myoepithelium, which is the outer layer that rests on the basement membrane. The basement membrane is hard to observe on this slide, but it is the eosinophilic area which separates the ductal system from the adjacent stroma. In examining the stroma, we can divide it into the interlobular stroma surrounding the terminal duct lobular units and large ducts, and the intralobular stroma, which surround the acini within the TDLU. The interlobular stroma consists primarily of fibroconnective tissue, fibroblast, myofibroblast, and adipose tissue, the latter representing the majority of the adult breast volume, as we can see as these round white spaces. You can also see blood vessels, lymphatics, and nerves in the interlobular stroma. The intralobular stroma surround the acini that are in the terminal duct lobular units. It appears looser than the interlobular stroma, as seen here. This picture, URH 169, is one of a lactational breast. The epithelium of a lactiferous breast undergoes a hyperplastic change with an increase in the size of the lobules as well as an increase in the number of lobules. You can see here how the luminal epithelial cells become enlarged with a vacuolated cytoplasm. In summary, the stroma, the luminal cells, and the myoepithelium are all important to the histology of the breast. That concludes our review of the normal histology of the breast.